it's Emmeline from SweetEmelyne's. So today I'm going to show you guys how to make a drip cake. I've been seeing these all over Instagram and I've been wanting to make one. I thought they were extremely hard to make, and actually as I was making it, I was realizing they actually are not hard to make at all. So I know you guys are going to love making this as much as I did. If you guys want to learn how to make it, then just keep watching.
So for this cake, I am using a cake box. You guys can of course make your cake from scratch if you would like. So I'm just following the directions on the back of the box and making my cake batter. Now I have a small cake pan and I'm going to be adding in half of the batter to this, and then I'm going to be baking it and then taking it out and adding in the batter again. Of course, it would be a lot easier if I just had two of these pans, but I only had one, so I had to repeat the process twice. Once they are out and cooled, we can trim off the excess layer of cake at the top, and this is going to help to even out the cake so that they are a lot easier once we layer them together. So now comes the fun part. We can decorate our cake. So for this next part, we're gonna be needing some frosting, an ice cream cone, chocolate, red food dye, nerds rope, and some sprinkles. So I'm just using this frosting, which I got from Michael's. I like this one a lot because it's really easy to use with cakes. So we're gonna take this and put it on our first layer of cake, and we're just going to spread this evenly. Now we can place our other piece of cake on top. So now we're gonna be making a crumb coat layer of frosting on the cake, and this is basically just to make sure any of the crumbs that were gonna come out on the frosting will come out on this part. So it'll help to make our final layer of frosting extra smooth. I'm just gonna place this in the freezer for about 30 minutes or until the frosting has hardened. So in the meantime, we can make our frosting. So I just added the Wilton frosting into a bowl and added in 2 drops of red food coloring to get a light pink color. So now it's time to apply our final layer of frosting. So I'm just taking an offset spatula, which I got from Michael's, and I'm just applying the frosting to the cake. I started on the sides and then worked my way up to the top. So a tip that I recommend is taking a glass of hot water and then taking a thicker spatula and running the spatula through the water and then running this over the cake. It helps to make the layer of frosting a lot smoother. So now I'm taking the excess pieces of cake that we cut off on the beginning, and I'm going to add this into a bowl and just kind of break it apart. Now I'm taking a fork and really mashing this down so that they are formed into crumbs. Next, I'm taking about a tablespoon of frosting and adding this in and mixing it together. It's going to form almost like a dough kind of consistency, so we can place this into our hand and begin to form a ball. This is going to be looking like the ice cream, so you kind of want to keep measuring it up with your ice cream cone. You guys can make it big or small. I decided to make mine oversized, but you guys can make it smaller if you would like. So next we're going to be making the chocolate to go all over our cake. So I'm just taking some milk and adding it into my skillet, and I'm just heating that up. Once the milk is heated up, I added in about a cup or so of chocolate, and you can do this over a double boiler system. I never have any trouble with my chocolate melting, so I just do it directly on the stovetop. Next, I'm taking my cone and I'm just dipping it in some chocolate, and then we can take that and dip it into sprinkles. So now I'm gonna place our cake pop onto our cake, and now I'm gonna take some of the chocolate and just begin to drizzle it over the sides of the cake. You guys can make your drips thick or thin. It just depends on how much chocolate you put over the sides. So now I'm just taking the remaining of the chocolate and I'm just going to put it all over our cake pop and all over the base of the cake. I'm also adding on top the ice cream cone. And before this hardens, you guys will want to put sprinkles all over it to make it look like an ice cream cone that is melted over. Lastly, I took the Nerds rope and I just put 2 around the edges of the cake just to give it a little extra touch, and I decided to go back in and add some more chocolate to melt over the Nerds rope. I think this cake came out so cool.
So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye! So if you guys enjoyed today's video, then be sure to give this a thumbs up and also leave me a comment down below telling me which type of video you guys would like to see next. Don't forget to subscribe to DreamWorks TV and also click around for more fun videos.